Good evening, everybody. So today we will be ending lifespan psychology with block 4, unit 4. That is challenges and issues in aging process. So we have seen the entire lifespan so far, that is, you know, from the child is in the womb, in the mother's womb. So like when he comes out of it, like he's an infant and, you know, early childhood, adolescence, early adulthood, middle adulthood, late adulthood, right? So these are the processes. So today we will be learning challenges and issues in aging processes. When a person is aging, what are the challenges and issues he or she faces? As soon as an individual is born, the body begins to age, right? Change is constant. So aging is also constant. Aging is also known as senescence. Is not simply about age. It is a unitary, coordinated, and continuous process that accumulates changes in organisms or objects over time. And every human being goes through this. Every human being ages. There is no one who can say that, you know, he never aged. It also involves multidimensional changes such as physical, psychological, cultural, and social levels. So change does not mean only in the physical body, you know, it's not just your physique. It's also your psychological, you go through psychological changes, cultural changes, and in social levels as well. The process of aging in the human body is inevitable and it stretches out for our entire life cycle like a rubber band, which extends the time we spent in infancy, childhood, adolescence, prime, and senior years. And as we age, there are a number of changes that takes place in the various systems of the human body, which may at times cause age-related problems and disorders. And there are also many signs of aging occurring both within and outside the human body. So when you're aging, your body, you know, when I see you from outside, I can just say, okay, you're aging, right? And also, you can see yourself that you're aging from inside and outside as well. Although aging is an ongoing process, the value of aging is seen differently at different points in the process. Some of the changes are anticipated with joy, such as baby's first tooth or first step. Right, so entire family celebrates that. It's a celebration time. Other changes are greeted with a less positive response, such as pulling out the first gray hair that appear. I mean, that happens at any age these days. No talking about this. Aging is also associated with increased risk of physical and cognitive decline. So your physical strength just comes down with aging. Your cognitive ability comes down or it declines when you're aging. Aging causes more amount of reduction in the rate of human cell multiplication. So your cells are multiplying, right? So with aging, even that multiplication of cells declines and also causes some of the cells to function inappropriately. It also interferes with the growth and development of the body tissues, which leads to the development of various immune system related disorders. The intensity of problems and challenges due to aging depends on a combination of both genetic and environmental factors. See, aging is again the challenges that you face, the problems that you come across while aging. It is again genetic and environment. Right, both are responsible for this. Now, genetic factors seem to be more powerful than environmental factors in determining the large differences among people in aging and lifespan. So there were a lot of cases, right, when we had an argument or a debate over, you know, most of the things we used to think, okay, it is all environmental or it is nurture, but most of the things is all nature or genetics. So genetics play a very huge role or a vital role. Hence, some of the aspects of the aging process may differ from person to person. Just give me a second. Yes, thank you. And aging is an inevitable natural process. And there is no treatment for aging process, right? You can't, even if you do plastic surgery or anything, you know, aging is not going to stop. Within you, you know, all the chemical reaction that's happening, that you age from inside also, right? So that is going to happen. You can't do anything about it. There's no magic for this. Eating right, but eating right and exercising will keep one's body healthier and may stave off some of the effects of aging, or at least slow the aging process. So with right diet, you know, right food, nutritious food and exercise, to an extent, you can control aging. You know, you can slow down that process, but the process is continuous. It is going to take place. The aging process in women also slightly differs from the aging process in men. So in men and women, aging process differs, be it physical, cognitive, psychological, social, or anything. Now let's see aging process in women, how women goes through this process. The aging process involves changes in physical, social, psychological conditions of a person. Let's see what are the challenges she faces in physical aspect. That is, menopause is the first thing that comes to mind when we are aging, right? That immediately comes to your mind when we say aging in women. The women's life is divided into two phases, that is premenopausal and postmenopausal. So before menopause and after menopause. The hormonal changes in the body cause many aging problems. The body starts losing out on bone mass and muscle strength. These weak bones often result in osteoporosis and arthritis, which accompany the woman throughout the rest of her life. The skin becomes sunken and sallow, and eventually wrinkles begin to appear, right? On your body, on your face, you can see on your neck. Especially when you see the neck, no, it is clearly visible, okay, this woman is aging. The immune system is no longer able to produce sufficient antibodies, therefore making the body susceptible to various illness. So when your body is not making antibodies, you are prone to illness frequently. Most vital organs show diminished performance. So all the important organs, all the vital organs of your body, again, the performance comes down, the function slows down, which affects the entire health of the woman. Now, what are psychological changes? As women are no longer fertile, right, after menopause, it is enough to send many women into depression. Women goes into depression when she gets to know, okay, now she is no more fertile, so she goes into depression. Emotional insecurity haunts their mind due to the fear that since she is no longer physically attractive. So she feels, this is all psychological changes that goes through. So after you age, right? See, every woman I think is beauty conscious. At least most of them are beauty conscious, right? So it's like, I don't know, most of the people I hear, you know, in my friend circle also. So even if they visit a doctor and the doctor happens to ask, what's your age? It's very, I don't know, because I have my family doctors as well. So they share that, you know, the women at that time also, they hide their age. So they are so conscious about their age, about their aging, you know, psychologically. And when they get to know that they are no more attractive, that actually puts them into depression. They may become extremely moody and irritated, as they may not be able to cope with the many changes that happen all at once in her life. There is this daunting feeling of aging that she somehow relates with the end. So she feels aging means end at the end, you know, that's how it is. But no matter what, whether you accept or not, it is true, right, that you're aging. Now, what are social challenges that she faces? She faces, not he, because we are discussing about women's aging processes. That is challenges that a woman faces. So now we are discussing social challenges. During aging process in women, their social life entirely depends upon their own attitude towards life. And most importantly, their health. And when you say women in your own families, no, when you compare men and women, it is women who always do not prioritize her health over the family members, be it her spouse or kids. She will, you know, never fail to take care of the entire family but herself. So it again depends on the woman's attitude about her health or anything. Some women, due to their poor health or some other reason, may completely shut themselves away from the world. Absolutely, if you don't take care of your health, you will fall sick and you shut yourself from the world. While the other, more outgoing group may engage themselves in community activities or some hobbies and interests. So there are two kinds of women here again. Some people, they try, you know, they want to be isolated. Again, the reasons are bad due to poor health and many other reasons. Now, there is another woman who is an outgoing person who loves to socialize. So she would go for kitty parties and a lot of things because that's what I used to see in my home. Yeah. So, yeah, so far we discussed aging in women. So that was physical challenges, right, related to menopause, premenopause and postmenopause. The second is psychological challenges, that she feels she's no more attractive and she goes into depression and other things. The next is social challenges that a woman faces. Next, let us look into aging process in men. How men age? What is the process here? Aging process in men does not treat all the men in the same way. For men, aging process has always been related with the decrease of mental and physical functions. And it also brings physiological changes in the body, right? Whole health. Now, let us just see the health. When the aging process starts, eating right kind of food becomes not only important to remain healthy, but it also becomes a necessity. Consistent, moderate exercise promotes cardiovascular health as well as reduces the risk factors for obesity, diabetes, and osteoporosis. See, even suppose you're a person who is age, say, 70-year-old, and you want to eat samosa, kachori, chaats and all. Do you think you can digest that? No. So eating healthy is not just to remain healthy, you know, eating right food. It is also your necessity now. You should take in what your body is asking, not unnecessarily trouble your digestive system or unnecessarily eat sweets and get diabetes and other things. Mental health. Mental health is an important concern for many men, as Alzheimer's disease and dementia, which are common to occur during this age, may afflict the individual. So Alzheimer's, again, is very common, right? Memory loss, that's related to memory loss. So anybody, actually after 30 also, everything just declines. Physical health, mental health, everything just declines. Again, in old age, what happens? It is at peak. So people definitely have this short-term memory loss. So suppose, you know, they have to remember something. They have to do some work after 15 minutes, say. So after 15 minutes, they forget what they had to do. So yeah, that's how it is like. Yeah, again, after a few seconds also, they can forget. So that's short-term memory loss. And that's very common, especially in men. Heart health. How about the heart now? Cardiovascular disease is still among the most common causes of death among men. Diet and lifestyle play a significant role in the progression of cardiovascular disease and are also central to its treatment. When you talk about heart health, again, this is also very common in men when compared to women. And again, you know, if you see the studies, you know, when you compare men and women, it is men who are likely to get heart attacks more again, you know, compared to women. Why? It's all psychological because, you know, women tend to share the issues, share the problems with their relatives, with their families, whereas men don't. And that's why all these happen to men. Prostate health. What happens to their prostate health now? Prostate health is a consideration for men once they reach the age of 40. Over the age of 40, it is estimated that 60% of men will have an enlarged prostate, also known as BPH, benign prostatic hyperplasia. As men age, the likelihood that they will end up they will develop BPH increases. Now, skeletal health. What happens to their skeletal health? Joint and bone health issues are also common problems for men, in which past sport injuries and wear and tear can lead to osteoarthritis. As one ages, our connective tissue is not able to repair itself as efficiently as when we were younger. Obviously, when we are younger, you get any kind of injury, any wound you come across, what happens? You recover very fast, right? Both physically as well as mentally. And when you, as and when you're aging, you have to be very careful because these injuries are very common. So once you fall, once your bone breaks or anything happens, any fracture, it becomes, it takes a lot of time for you to recover. And sometimes it could be fatal. Sometimes it may so happen that, entire life you end up suffering because the process, the healing process is way too slow. The aging process is a natural one. Aging, however, does not have to mean loss of function or vitality. In fact, healthful eating habits in combination with focused nutrients and herbs can combine to make the 40 plus years the best of any man's life. The other day we just saw, right, that once you reach even the age of 30, you need to take care of your health. That's the time when you need to become serious about your health, be it physical or mental. So you should start taking care. You should not wait for the old age that, you will take care when you reach 40, 50 or 60. Now let us see difference in aging in both men and women. So aging process in men and women work at different pace, different speed, right? In men, it causes a sense of insecurity about the future. Men are insecure, just as it does in the case of women. So what happens to men? Men have skin which is approximately 25% thicker than women's. So men's skin is thicker when compared to women. Women's skin is initially thinner and remains the same until about the age of 50, where it also begins to become thinner. So women's skin is already thinner. And after 50, it becomes even more thinner. And for men, aging is more gradual. It is slow. For women, aging is a sudden change. Suddenly they'll change, right? They're like beautiful, young and all that. Again, within a couple of years, you see they completely change. They look different. In men, testosterone levels declining slowly over time, a process sometimes called andropause. And in women, menopause, which happens around the age of 50.
Andropause is the menopause for men.
For men, yesterday you were talking about
this. As I was mentioning yesterday.
Yes, you were mentioning about it, yes. And men usually gain weight until their mid-50s, when their weight starts to drop off again. So until 50, they gain. After that again, their weight starts dropping off again. Women typically gain weight for an extra decade, 10 years. That's very bad. Until age 65. And women tend to live longer than men. Men are more likely to suffer from heart disease at a younger age than women. Women are more susceptible to the signs of aging. Men also have a higher collagen content, which results in less wrinkling. Depending on genetics and hormones, men usually experience pattern baldness more often than women. Okay, chalo, this we are fine with it. Older men are far more satisfied with their sexual relations than women. And why do, when you just take spouses, right, older spouses, so somebody at the age of, 80s, so there is a couple who are in their 80s. So if a woman loses her husband, she still lives for a long time, like as much as she is meant to live. But if a man loses his wife, it becomes very difficult for that man to live without his wife because he's emotionally dependent on her only. Because at that time, he values his relationships more. Whereas, what happens when it comes to women, we find our happiness in the smallest of the things, in our children, our grandchildren. But when it comes to men, they are not like women. So that is one reason that when a man loses his wife, he doesn't live longer. He might live just for a couple of months or couple of days or couple of years. He might not survive without her. But women generally live a longer time. Even if she loses her husband in a young age, she lives her entire life. Aging issues and challenges in middle adulthood. So middle adulthood refers to the people whom are experiencing changes and development in their central lives now. It is basically about the midlife transition or the period of life beyond young adulthood, but before the commencement of old age. So the physical appearance, let's just see how they appear. The changes in physical appearance are some of the most notable parts for many people as they experience middle adulthood physical development. What happens in middle adulthood now? The hair begins turning gray or white. More wrinkles appear, especially on the face. You can, I think, look yourself if you are in your middle adulthood. Teeth fade from white to yellow. Skin begins to sag. What happens to hearing and vision? The ability to hear high-pitched noises disappears during middle adulthood as most people begin recognizing hearing loss around 40. Men experience twice as much hearing loss as women during this life stage that is in their 40s. Vision also decreases for both sexes. So vision is again decreasing. There's no partiality in the vision. Health. The experience of health decline is different for men and women, though death is fewer for females than in males. Men are more prone to heart diseases, cancer, or stroke. Women are prone to known fatal illness. They might not die. That is goiter, gout or arthritis, lung, and breast cancer. The gain or loss in this domain generally depends on how people take care of themselves while they're still young and capable to do so. So again, all the things, you know, whatever we saw, heart disease, cancer, stroke, arthritis, or breast cancer or anything. Again, it depends on you, how you take care of your health. So with the right diet and the right exercise, I think you can avoid all these things, right? Prevention is better than cure. Now, what happens to the strength and coordination? As adults pass through middle adulthood, the strength begins to diminish as some of their muscles is replaced with fat now. Flexibility also decreases and the reaction time of individuals in middle adulthood decreases as well. What happens to sexuality now? The start of middle adulthood often signifies the end of a woman's ability to bear children. That is, she is no more fertile. They proceed to go through menopause during this middle age stage in their life. And men still possess the ability to reproduce. Also, their fertility decreases in middle adulthood as they age. They can reproduce, but fertility decreases. Relationships. What happens to relationships during middle adulthood? During middle adulthood, the two primary long-term relationship characteristics are cohabitation and marriage. What is cohabitation? Cohabitors are unmarried people living together in a sexual relationship. Live in relationship. Often state their reason for cohabiting as either a trial for marriage or an alternative to marriage. And marriage, you all know, right? It is a formal event. Yes. Marital satisfaction is often described in terms of a U-curve. People generally affirm that their marriages are happiest during the early years, but not as happy during the middle years. So during the early years of your wedding, generally couple are happy. I mean, that's according to the book, not me. Marital satisfaction then increases again in the later years, in the old age. Once finances have stabilized and parenting responsibilities have ended. So once you're done with your parenting, once your children grow up and they are married or they go away, again, you know, the couples start focusing on each other. Again, they come close. Middle adults are not immune to problems in relationships. The reasons for dissolving a relationship are many and varied. few of them are the couple cannot handle an extended crisis. So any crisis, they'll just break up. Divorce. The spouses change and grow in different directions. Again, two people going in two different directions, state, countries, or whatever, long distance relationship, or many things. The spouses are completely incompatible from the very start. The reason why they came together could be, the reason itself could be wrong. Love changes over time, and such changes may become evident by middle adulthood, right? We learned in previous classes that again, just once you get married, just for a year, it is like a honeymoon period. Later, again, it takes place, you know, it becomes attachment, love, these, that, a lot of things. So definitely there is changing. The ideal form of love in adulthood involves three components we learned, that is passion, intimacy, and commitment, which termed consummate love or complete love. So all the things put together termed as complete love. I think we learned in the previous class and we don't need to learn again. For many middle-aged couples, passion fades as intimacy and commitment build. So when you are, if you're in this middle, you know, adulthood, you will see that here passion fades away, a little at least. It's not just about sexuality, you know, it's not about physical intimacy now. It's just intimacy and commitment which is there now. Which is important. It's not that this is only there. Now, priority is intimacy and commitment, the bonding. Long-term relationships share several factors, including both partners regarding the relationship as a long-term commitment. Both verbal and physical expressing appreciation, admiration, and love, offering emotional support to each other, considering the other as a best friend. So all these are the factors, you know, which both should consider in a long-term relationship or a commitment. So there has to be a you know, both verbal and physical expression of love through your, you know, appreciation, admiring the partner. And whenever they are in need of emotional support, you need to be there. And also you need to be their friend. That's most important, I guess. Essential to preserve a quality relationship is a couple's decision to practice effective communication. Without communication, everything, every relationship dies. It's not just between the spouses or between the couple, anything, even within the family. So communication is the key. Communication is the mean by which intimacy is established and nurtured within a relationship. It helps partners to relate and understand each other better. Communication helps them feel close, connected, and loved. Friends. Now, what is the importance of friends during this age? Which age? Middle adulthood. During this period, life responsibilities are at an all-time high. So you know, you feel that you're very responsible. You have no time and all that. So having extra time for socializing is usually rare during this time. For this reason, middle adults have less friends than their newly or retired counterparts. So, you know, at our age, I think we have a lot of friends. It's fine. But when you have more responsibilities, when you age, you are in the middle adulthood. Again, your responsibility is increasing and friendship just comes down because you have no time. And again, when all you know, you fulfill all the responsibilities, you know, your children are grown up now and they're also married or something. And now again, you have time for friends. So you start meeting your friends, you start socializing. Yet where quantity of friendship may be lacking, quality predominates. So now you don't want to have hundreds of friends. Now you just want one or two good friends, you know, who you can rely, you can trust, you can share your feelings. Some of the closest ties between friends are formed and nourished during middle adulthood. Now, what happens to the children? Middle adults and their adolescent children are both prone to emotional crises, which may occur at the same time. For adolescents, the crisis involves the search for identity. See, we already learned, right? So what happens to the children who are just reaching their adolescence? So they face this identity crisis and all that because there is a conflict between the parents and the children now. So parents also goes through this turmoil, right? it's not just the children who are worried, you know, it's not just the children who are all the time tensed and searching for the identity. Even parents are worried now what to do, you know, how to, you know, convince a child if they're taking a wrong step. Now, how can I help the child? Even they want to do, you know, so they are also in the confusion. They also need counseling. So these two crises are not always compatible. As parents try to deal with their own issues as well as those of their adolescents. So parents being very responsible, they have to take care of finances and other stuff along with their kids. So there are certain ways, you know, how you can help, like taking music lessons, attend a certain college and join a sport team or enter the family business as well. They may try to make their teenage children into improved versions of themselves. That's what parents think. Okay, I want my child to be a doctor because I'm a doctor. Okay, I was not like this. I did not do like this. So my child has to do like this. So everything they could not do, they literally try that their children, you know, do it. And parents, most middle adult characterize the relationship with their parents as affectionate and during this age. Indeed, a strong bond is often present between related middle and older adults. One issue facing middle adult is caring for their aging parents. So during this age, because you also have children, right? And you have parents too. So sometimes, no, you see your kids and you realize that, yeah, the way you, you know, tortured your parents. So you are more empath towards your parents. You are very caring at this age towards your parents. So any doubts so far? Or are you people sleeping or awake, or I'm not sure?
Not asleep. You can go ahead. No doubts.
Okay.
Yeah, fine, ma'am.
Okay, so aging issues and challenges in late adulthood. So what happens in late adulthood? That is old age. Aging may be inevitable, but the rate of aging is not. The human body goes through a variety of changes as it gets older and older and older. In general, muscles, blood vessels, and other tissues lose their elasticity. The heart becomes less efficient. Bones are weaker, metabolism slows down, so you have to take care of what you're eating. In spite of the changes of the rest of the body, a lot of people focus primarily on changes of their appearance as they age, of course, right? Which includes wrinkles. So you will see a lot of, if you see a person who is age 65 and above, first thing what you can notice is they have a lot of wrinkles. Fibers in the skin called collagen and elastin break down and lose their strength as a person gets older and older. Sun exposure throughout life contributes to this process. So sometimes too much exposure to the, you know, sun also leads to more wrinkles. Without these fibers, the skin cannot hold its shape as well. Older skin retains less fat, making it look less supple. The pull of gravity also causes the skin to sag, which is very bad. Dry skin. Older people produce less sweat and oil, causing their skin to be drier. Excessively dry skin can emphasize the appearance of your wrinkles. So somebody who has dry skin already, you know, in future, you're going to have your skin more dry. And someone with oily skin, at least yours will be better. Yeah. Age spots. What happens? What is this age spots now? So dark spots in the skin, particularly the arms, hands, face and feet, stem from cumulative exposure to the sun. They actually stem from overproduction of the pigment melanin in areas of the skin that have experienced the most exposure to the sun. So next time you go out in the sun, again, anything in excess is poison.
Wear sunscreen.
With the, you know, advice of the doctor, not everybody says that it is good. Yeah.
Obesity. Use aloe vera best.
Okay. Obesity and metabolic syndrome. What happens here? Now, it is seen that most of the adults age 60 and older are overweight or obese. Obesity is related to type 2 diabetes, cardiovascular disease, breast and colon cancer, gallbladder disease, and high blood pressure during this age, 60 and above. Women in premenopause and menopause tend to accumulate fat around the waist and hips, and men get the gut. Arthritis. Arthritis affects nearly half the elderly population and is a leading cause of disability. Managing one's weight is just as essential for joint health. Yes. Osteoporosis and falls. Falls is injuries, right? Sometimes if you fall, that could again lead to unnecessary, you know, fatal accidents or again, a lot of issues. Osteoporosis and low bone mass affect most of the adults age 50 and older. Most of them are women here. Cancer. Risk of developing most type of cancer increases with age. As women age, the rate of cervical cancer decreases and endometrial cancer increases. The risk of prostate cancer increases with age, and black men have a higher rate than white men. Lung cancer accounts for more deaths than breast cancer, prostate cancer, and colon cancer combined. Vision and hearing loss. What happens to your vision? Again, your eyesight. Yeah, of course, it is reducing for both the genders. Age-related eye diseases such as macular degeneration, cataract, diabetic retinopathy, and glaucoma affect people age 40 and older. The incidence of hearing loss increases with age. So you have hearing issues as well. Mental health. What happens to your mental health? Memory and emotional well-being. Staying mentally active is as important as staying physically active. So since we are doing psychology, we are learning how important mental health is. It is as equal to physical health. One of the perplexing problems of aging is Alzheimer's disease, that is memory loss. Depression is often underdiagnosed and untreated. Many people mistakenly believe that depression is a natural condition of old age, which is not. Again, yesterday we were talking, Vasudha was saying that, you know, old age, or like people also suicide in old age. So there is one, I would not like to mention which community it is, but there is a community in which, you know, if you want, once you're old or something, I'm not sure whether it is, it happens only during old age, you can actually starve to death. And your family is not forcing you to eat food or something. You decide and the family is okay with it. Yes. Yeah, that is it.
Again, I do not think Okay, I'm going to stop recording. Is it okay?
Yes.
Okay.